It is 20 minutes before 10 o'clock, and what a great way to end the work week. Charlie is in the house.
Of course, that would be Deon Cole, whose character Charlie was so popular on the TV show Black-ish that he got his own spinoff in Grown-ish. He's also one of the leads in the new TBS show Angie Tribeca, where he plays a detective produced by Steve Carrell. Deon, welcome back to
Hello.
Memphis. Welcome Thank back you. To Live Thank at 9. Man, how is life these days, man, for you?
No sleep. I'll tell you that much.
But this is
but
what...
But it's all good.
It's all good. Yeah. Good.
Man, yeah. You are riding such
Thank
a wave.
You.
Well,
Thank
let's
you.
Talk about the newest thing first, Angie Tribeca. It's about a group of detectives. What's the story?
It's a spoof. It's a spoof show, like, remember Airplane and Naked Gun?
Yeah, definitely
like that.
So. Definitely.
Okay. Yeah, it's Rashida Jones and Steve Carrell produced or whatever. And yeah, it's a good show. And also, Black-ish and Grown-ish is what I do. And
talk about the popularity of those shows and your character, because when I watch it, you know, I'm wondering, is he writing his own stuff there? I mean, what influence do you have? Because we know you well.
Yeah, no. My writing, I wrote for Conan for several years, and I still get down with Conan. I still
O'Brien.
Do bits with Conan.
Right.
Yeah, that's how
I don't know
like,
how you have
started.
Time.
Yeah, no. So when I went over to Black-ish, I went over there to write. I wasn't going over there to be on the show.
Really?
But then the character I play is Charlie, which was supposed to be Charlie Murphy.
Okay.
He didn't want to do the character, and so I
the late Charlie Murphy didn't want to do. Wow.
Seriously.
Yeah, that's how that happened. Yep. So I just ended up happening to be at the right place.
You
at the,
own it.
But you own it. Yeah, because your character.
Yeah,
I mean,
I was supposed to write the character, so I knew the character. I was writing for the character.
So and is so that I why knew it worked so well, you think?
I would think that. That's what it was. I think so, yeah, because I knew what I was going to write for Charlie.
Yeah.
And so Grown-ish, you play a professor.
Yeah. We just spent off. Yara Shahidi, shout out to Yara, and myself, we went over and, we did a... Grown-ish.
With a bunch of millennials.
Yeah.
You got me wondering, where do you think we're headed, though, on a slightly more serious note, with TV these days? Because it seems like we're seeing... as we should, more minority characters, whether they're African American, Asian American, Latino American. Where do you think we're going now?
I mean, I like where it's going. I mean, it shows that we have a voice, you know, and it shows that, you know, we have stories as well, you know. It used to be a time on television where it was just like, you know, they'll have a black face on a show.
Right, you're the sidekick.
Right.
Exactly.
But we never were a voice. And so now I think we have a lot of black voices rather than just black faces. Mm-hmm. And so that's what all these great shows are doing, you know, like Black-ish or Insecure or Atlanta.
Yeah.
Like
we're
all pushing the boundaries and pushing it forward and telling our story. So it's a great movement. I'm glad to have been a part of opening that door.
And definitely so you still are doing stand-up. What do you get from that live stand-up audience? Because he's at Chuckles.
It's therapeutic because what I think can't be on Black-ish.
That says a lot right there without saying a lot.
We'll not be on Black-ish. We will not see a Juneteenth episode.
No Juneteenth episode.
No. So that's what the comedy club is for.
So it's really to save you money on the psychotherapist couch.
And lawyer fees.
And lawyer fees.
And saves me lawyers.
Has any of this, though, your star power these days, has it changed you at all? Because you can just see folks in our studio just standing around and see you.
It's all love. Yeah, no, it's been crazy. You know, everywhere I go, man, it's always love and I always touch the people. You know, I'm big on, you know, if somebody want a picture, I give it to them, you know, because that... I remember when I used to see people that I saw on television and me taking a picture with them was everything. That's like lifelong promotion.
Yeah.
You know, because I still talk about the time I met Prince and Clint Eastwood.
Keep talking.
Over just a second.
Keep talking.
Just a second.
Exactly.
I made that second into a whole day.
And
you
that's
know?
So awesome to hear.
So
they're
so
the
great.
Reason you are riding
right,
high.
Right, and so that's
you know?
Why I try to do
it's
the
so
same
awesome
thing, you know, like
that.
Definitely, man. Come on out to the show. We're going to have a good time this weekend. Chuckles Comedy Club. Be there. Hit me on my Instagram, DEONCOLE. Follow me on there.
And maybe even take a picture.
Take it. You know, I always
we gotta,
do.
We got to take that
I'll
picture.
I'll be dead tired. Look, I've been in so many pictures like this.
Here, let's take one now.
I'll be so tired.
That's a good looking picture there. For sure.
I want this picture. That's it.